school. This is 2020 graduation in fine virtual style. We welcome you, those who are near, those who are far. We welcome you. We are sorry you could not be here with us today, but nevertheless, you are here. Ladies and gentlemen, we start our program by singing, Great is Thy Faithfulness.
You mean that you'll be in class of 2019.
the virtual way. As we collect moments like this, I'm going to invite us to pray. At this time, I'm going to ask the graduates who are seated here and those who are visiting or celebrating in some form or another to stand while Minister Reverend Janet comes forward with prayer.
Bless his holy name. You want to praise him as if it's the last praise? Just do it from your heart. Praise his holy name. At this time, let us look to the Lord in prayer. Kind loving Father and our God, the maker of heaven and earth, the God who knows the end from the beginning. Hallelujah. From everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Lord, you made the heavens. You made the earth. You made the sea, Lord, and all that is therein. You are the Most High God. We give you honor, glory, and praise at this hour. Thank you, O God, as we gather here, O God, for this virtual graduation class. My God, we pray that you would intervene right now. Help us, mighty God, whatever we do from here on, my God, it will always be a blessing. We pray, God, that you will set the angels in charge of this graduating class. And so, God, we pray that you will bless them as they continue, Lord, from here on. Oh, God, the new normal, for you are God. And, Lord, we pray at this hour that as we are so special today, we will continue that way. Bless, oh, God, the teachers, oh, God, and everyone else who have put this together. My God, we pray that you will help them as you give them knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. We pray, God, for everyone who participate in this morning. God, we pray that you will bless them, going, coming, lying down, getting up. Oh, God, we pray that you'll always be with them. And so, God, we pray, hallelujah, for this campus, my God, that it will continue to be a special place. And God, we look forward, because it is the future we are looking to right now. We pray, God, that the next time around, if you tarry, God, we can celebrate from a university point of view. Bless us now, we pray. Bless the day's activity. Help us, mighty God. Hallelujah. That in all of this, you will get the honor, the glory, and the praise. Have your divine way now, we pray. And we look to you and tell you thanks. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the blessed Holy Ghost. In Jesus Christ's holy name we pray. Amen. Praise God.
Thank you, Leon and Jared. At this time, we are going to be having the scripture reading. But before we do so, I just want to say to the graduating class of 2020, and see how I'm smiling up here, but make sure we put on the best dress for them. Yes? Yes, let me show you. You're not here, and I make sure I dress up for you because you're so special to me. Class of 2020, collect moments, not things. Obstacles don't have to stop you. If you have run into a wall, don't turn around and give up. Figure it out. Find a way to climb over it. Find a way to go around it. Find a way to get through it. But never, ever give up. Ms. Didridan, could you come with the word?
Please stand for the reading of the word. This morning's scripture will be taken from Colossians chapter 1, verse 9 to 12. And so, from the day we heard, we have not ceased to pray for you, asking that you may be filled with the knowledge of His will in all spiritual wisdom and understanding, so as to walk in a manner worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing to Him, bearing fruit in every good way and increasing in the knowledge of God. May you be strengthened with all power according to His glorious might for all endurance and patience with joy, giving thanks to the Father who has qualified you in the inheritance of the saints in life. This is the name of God, holy name. Thanks be to God.
Class of 2020, you have been through a lot, but nevertheless, we have made it to the end. When we came off in March 13, that blessed day when the bell rang and some of you shouted, "Woohoo! We are going home, COVID!" You never knew that we would still be out in such a time like this. Well, guess what? Situations create new experiences. And so this afternoon, we are having a new experience. A new situation has turned up on our island. And as a result of that, we are enjoying something different. Do not look on not being here as an obstacle, but look at it as a new situation. I am encouraging you that as you go through life from 2020 onwards, there will be obstacles. But guess what? I know that we have been prepared enough to rise above the obstacles and make something great in our lives. Ladies and gentlemen, at this moment, I would love to invite our chairman of the board and former chief education officer, Mr. Jasper Lawrence.
Miss Allen, Master of Ceremonies, Mrs. Shaw McCain, Deputy Superintendent of Police and our guest speaker, our chaplain, Reverend Chaluba, Mr. Dwight Oilett, representative of the Ministry of Education, Youth and Education Regional Office, Region 2, PTA President, Pastor Asper Jarrett, Mr. Michael Watkins, Vice President of Overseas Chapter of the Iona Past Student Association, Madam Principal, Mrs. Humes Johnson, Vice Principal Mrs. Armstrong, other members of the academic staff, members of the support staff, admin and ancillary, ladies and gentlemen, students, and most importantly, members of our graduating class, I greet you well. It is a good feeling to come to the time of another graduation exercise, in spite of the challenges of COVID-19. But I would like to at this point congratulate all of those persons who have contributed to your reaching this very important milestone today. I would like to express thanks to the parents, to the service providers, those who provided transportation, meal service, whatever. I'd like to express thanks to all the members of the Iona school community and to the Ministry of Education Regional Office for guiding the process so that today we could share with you in this graduation exercises. I just want to congratulate you on all the efforts you have put in, and I would like to congratulate especially those students who have attained special awards in the different subject areas for their good conduct and for their helpfulness and all the other areas for which special awards are presented. This is really not the end of the road for you, but whether you are going to be embarking on further studies or you are going into the world of work, you will have to take with you the good discipline, the values, and the attitudes that you have acquired not only from your homes, but more importantly, from the Iona High School. I trust that as you embark on your future, you will be good ambassadors of this noble institution. And I trust that you would have internalized fully well that with God all things are possible. So that whatever you are going to venture into, if you put God first and you put all of your efforts into it, it should pay you a rich dividend. I don't need to remind you that as we go into our future, living with COVID-19 around us, we are going to have to observe all the protocols that are required by the Ministry of Health and Wellness, all the protocols that are expected of us to observe by other government departments, so that we can keep safe, we can protect others and ourselves, and we can embark on our lives successfully. Without any further ado, I would like to wish for those of you who have not yet received your CSEC results, that when the results would have been out, you would have attained the standards for which you have worked. I wish that this ceremony will redound to the interest of everyone. May the Lord bless us all. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, in our midst today, we have a gentleman who is no stranger to education and no stranger to the Iona High School family. This young man I speak of is Mr. Dwight Hoylett, representative of the MOEYI for Region 2. Make him welcome.
Moderator, keynote speaker, distinguished guests, members of the school's board of management, Principal Mrs. Melva Humes-Johnson, Vice Principal Mrs. Armstrong, teachers, parents, graduates, other well-wishers, good afternoon. I have the pleasure of bringing to you greetings from the Ministry of Education, Youth and Information Region 2, and in particular our Regional Director, Ms. Janet Brim. The Ministry of Education, Youth and Information recognizes the hallmark of excellence that has over the years characterized the curricular offerings and outcomes across the spectrum at Iona High School. We are satisfied that the men and women who work hard each day in our school have provided you with an environment in which you are able to learn and grow. Today is indeed a very special day. It is special for the graduates, as it is special for who I'm very sure are some very relieved teachers, parents. You, however, will not be getting any relief as yet, because some of our students will be going off to higher studies, and some may be venturing in the world of work. Parents, your role in all of this is to continue to assist as much as you possibly can in preparing them for that next step in life. Graduates, we are proud of your accomplishments. And like your parents and family members, we share that sense of pride knowing that you've become young men and women ready for life's many challenges. As you celebrate, however, please be reminded that this graduation ceremony is not your destination. You have many, many miles left to cover. Ahead lies a wide world. It is a world of challenges which may not always be kind and caring. If you, however, want to realize continued success, you will need to have formidable strength of character and an unwavering determination. Seize your opportunities and set high goals for yourself and work hard to achieve them. We celebrate your success in your recently concluded CSE examinations and wish for your continued success in your future endeavors. It was James Allen who once wrote, "Dream lofty dreams, and as you dream, so shall you become. Your vision is the promise of what you shall one day be. Your ideal is the prophecy of what you shall at last unveil. Once again, congratulations to the class of 2020, and may God bless you all, and God bless Iona High School. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time it is my pleasure to introduce to you the Vice President of the Iona Past Student Association, Mr. Michael Watkiss.
Hello, everyone. My name is Michael Watkiss, and I'm the Vice President of the Iona Past Students Association, which is based in North America. On behalf of our President, Mr. Paul Brown, our Board of Directors, and our members globally, I'd like to congratulate the graduating class of 2020. Yes, you have done it. You have made it. I'm speaking to you from my home here in New York City, where just a few weeks ago was the epicenter of the deadly global pandemic we now know as COVID-19. That, at its peak, was taking some 800 people's lives per day. Yes, I said 800. It continues to plow a disruptive and deadly path across the United States and other parts of the world. It is a world where every day brings a new normal. Yes, a new normal, such as social distancing, wearing a face mask, and yes, virtual graduations, which we're a part of today. It's a pandemic that has radically changed our lives, that has radically transformed the world. So pretty much I've spent the past few months and the past few days or so thinking about change. I've been asking myself what, if any, changes that I have personally contributed to this world since I was graduated from Iona High School back in 1981. Yes, indeed, it's a long time ago, 1981. And that is a question I want to put before you today, class of 2020, your special day. What difference would you like to make as you plot your future into this changing world that I'm talking about? It might sound somewhat cliched, but I want to encourage you to be the change you wish to see in this world. Let me repeat it. I want to encourage you to be the change you wish to see in this world. Yes, I did not say try. I say be, because that is important. And why? Because I strongly believe it starts today, right here, right now, in such a time as this. Graduating class of 2020, you stand here today on the precipice of the future, your future. It is not a distant reality anymore. It's now. It begins here. It begins today. You began high school as children, but you are now leaving as adults. Yes, indeed, you have completed a basic education that will serve as the platform for you to launch yourselves into your future. Some of you will go on to college. Some of you indeed will go straight into the workforce, but each of you will travel your own path with boundless opportunities to be that change. Boundless opportunities to be that change. So no matter where you go or what you do, there always will be challenges ahead of you. But what I'm asking from you, each of you, as well as from myself, is to meet these challenges straight on, with your head held high and your hearts wide open. That is the Iona way. That's the Iona way that our founders, Mr. and Mrs. Swaby, envisioned 70 years ago when they founded Iona Schools. Class of 2020, it is not enough to simply try to get by in life. That does not move the world forward. That will not transform you into the game changer that I'm talking about. You must try to excel in everything you do. Strive for excellence, class of 2020. Excellence in every task, no matter how small or large. And although it may not be as easy as it seems to be, every single accomplishment you achieve is added to the world's accomplishment. You will be that change you wish to see. Your individual successes benefit society as a whole, because when you succeed, when you're a game changer, you lighten the burden of your fellow man. When you succeed, you're in a position to give rather than to take. Imagine if every individual lived up to his or her potential. Think about how amazing that would be and how much better off the world would be. Imagine if just half of those individuals lived up to their potential. The world would still be an awesome place. And even if a quarter of those individuals worked to make their lives successful, they would still make some amazing contribution to society. Well, you may not have the power to inspire the entire world. I'm not going to guarantee you that. But you can make a difference. So, class of 20, my challenge to each of you, as well as to myself again, is to do all that you can do to reach your full potential, to be a game changer. If every member of this graduating class is able to do that, just imagine what impact you can have on this world. The future is truly in your hands. So let's make most of it, class of 2020. Be a game changer, for with God, all things are possible. Thank you so much.
This afternoon, we have an extension of the high school, which is a group of students known as POS students. These students have grown in the institution as they were a part of the first group of CAP students that we had working with in a long time. The POS program includes hospitality and tourism, and these students are making waves in the institution. Our principal loves to call them our grade 12 and 13 students. Ladies and gentlemen, the grade 12 and 13 POS students will be giving their viewpoint of Iona High School and a year that is filled with excitement for them. Make welcome Mr. Jermel Peart and Miss Fredrina Sequoia. Put your hands together.
Madam Chairperson, Ms. Colleen Allen, Member of Parliament, Honorable Montague, the Speaker, Mrs. Dennis Shaw McCain, Deputy Superintendent of Police, Senior Education Officer for Region 2, Mrs. Yashika Blackwood Grant, Reverend Kaluba School Chaplain, Chairman of the School Board, Mr. Jasper Lawrence, Principal, Mrs. Melva Humes Johnson, Vice Principal, Mrs. Joan Peart Armstrong, Alumni President, Mr. Paul Brown, PTA President, Reverend Osborne Jarrett, members of staff, graduates, parents, well-wishers, good morning to you all. It has been a long, exciting, sad, and extremely memorable 2 years being a student of the Center of Occupational Studies. We had fun. We visited places, we met new faces, we all had our ups and downs, but most importantly, we all grew together as a family. Being the first batch of students to participate in the Hospitality and Tourism Management Program, the Lab Rats, was actually an honor for all individuals introduced to this program.
Our journey started in October of 2018. Where we were all too anxious to interact with each other. We have come such a far way since then. We started as strangers and are now ending as a family. In the 2 years we've been together, we've lived a lifetime of experiences, from traveling Jamaica from east to west, to creating our own haven in our classroom. We did it all. One of our most memorable moments was our first trip together. to a popular tourist attraction in Portland.
This is where what we had been learning was going to be put to the test. It was our first time experiencing bad customer service as a group. We were able to navigate using the skills we were taught and handle the matter in a professional manner.
For the first time in most of our lives, we visited McGrill. On our first trip, we attended the protocol training. This was where we got the opportunity to dress up, be fancy, and drink expensive wine. Our second visit to McGrill was the most memorable. We spent 2 weeks completing our work experience. Those 2 weeks were quite eventful. This is where Sashana learned that her bicycle riding skills were not up to par. Shanil discovered that there's more to life than bread. And we all learned that it was possible to shower with only 1 gallon of water. Our final visit to McGrill resulted in us getting closer as a class. We stayed at the luxurious Rondell Village. We enjoyed AC cooled rooms and breakfast served by the seaside. Although we had gone for the benefit of our education, we did not let that stop our fun. Let's just say it was an experience we'll never forget.
Our 2 years wouldn't have been the success it was if it wasn't for our teachers, mentors, and supporters. A special thanks to Mrs. Stacy Ricketts, our mother away from home. She's been with us through thick and thin. Whenever we felt like giving up, she was there to push us past the limit we placed on ourselves. Big up Mrs. Purcell Ward. Nothing beats her comedic, motivational speeches. She kept us laughing and happy on summer days. A big shout out to all other teachers. We salute you.
Although we will no longer be together in a physical space, the memories we made together will forever be in our hearts. I pray that we continue chasing our dreams, pursuing success, and though we'll be apart, the bond we formed will never be broken.
Staff, they have been crucial in our lives.
For the support and dedication they served us with, we say thank you. Thanks to the working teachers that were working with us. Our journey doesn't stop here. This graduation has already showed us how capable we all are of accomplishing our dreams when we commit ourselves to them. I hope all of us here today can take the personal accomplishments as an example of how anything is truly possible when we put our minds to it. As we all continue in our lives, let us take the new problem on with confidence, knowing that we have achieved great heights and are equipped with the necessary tools to tackle them. The road that lies ahead won't be easy. There will be roadblocks, missed exits, and obstacles. There will be times when each of us feel like giving up, or feel like we can't go on, or we are alone. But we are all in this journey together. We've made it this far. Why should we back down now? Nothing worthwhile is easy, and that includes making the most of our future. But it doesn't mean that we must give up on ourselves. We will keep pushing because we know we can achieve our dreams, and because we are worth it. From this day forward, let us make every decision with our best interest in mind. Let us believe in ourselves, so that we may reach our goals and fulfill our dreams. Congratulations. Congratulations. Congratulations to the class of 2020. We deserve to give ourselves a huge round of applause.
Some of us got to know our teachers a little bit better. Some of us ended up studying in the night, long hours with some of our teachers. Some of us got a break from some of the friends that we needed to get a break from. We love you, we love you, we love you. Yes, talk to Anna. We love you, we love you, we love you. But we were glad that you were out of the way so that we could study, study, study. Yes. So we know that with this situation, we know we anticipate great things coming from the class of 2020. Some of you shed some tears. You miss your friends. Yes. And you never sell out your friend them at any point. I saw one song said, never sell out my friend them. Mm-hmm. But you never put Christian in the world. Right? But we can't tell them that fiction. Right? But you know what? Take the moment. Enjoy the moment. And so we're going to be having a rendition from the choir members. And these choir members belong to the graduating class of 2020. Let me tell you something, they're going to clap themselves while they come. Clap yourself.
Getting it.
year 2019 to 2020. Make her welcome.
Graduation is an exciting time of change for all of those involved, and this is especially so for the graduates themselves. Today marks the end of an era for all our graduates as they say farewell to the safe haven of Iona High, their friends and the teachers, and open the door to their future. It is a future that, due to the ongoing impact of the COVID-19 pandemic, may seem quite foreboding and uncertain. However, I encourage you, as the Lord exhorted Joshua, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or discouraged, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. At Iona High School, you have had the opportunity to learn and grow, to fail and to try again. You are unique individuals, all with your own unique academic and physical talents. I hope that your years at Iona have given you the courage to follow your own heart and mind, and to listen always to the leading of the Lord in all that you do. Graduates, whatever the next step on your journey, may it be probably going off to college or accepting a job offer, I leave you with the words of Proverbs 16, verse 3. Commit to the Lord whatever you do, and your plans will succeed.
Class of 2020, we know you want to be heard. As a matter of fact, we have been hearing you for the past 4 years. And some of you have been loud, and some of you have been soft in speaking to us. But this is your moment to shine. And so, we are going to be having our valedictorian speaking to us in no other form than Lady Jordana Johnson and Lady Sanaya Gay. These are two fine young ladies. Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen.
Madam Chairperson, Ms. Kadeen Allen, Member of Parliament, Honorable Robert Montague, Guest Speaker, Mrs. Denise Shaw McCain, Deputy Superintendent of Police, Mrs. Yashika Blackwood Grant, Senior Educator Officer for Region 2, Chairman of the School Board, Mr. Jasper Lawrence, Principal, Mrs. Melba Hughes Johnson, Vice Principal, Mrs. John Pierce Armstrong, Chaplain of the School, Reverend Kaluba, Alumni President, Mr. Paul Brown, PTA President, Reverend Asburn Jarrett, members of the Academic, Administrative, and Auxiliary staff, my fellow graduates, parents, well-wishers, pleasant morning to you all. High school is where some of the most electrifying stages of life take place. High school was like being introduced to a whole other world. For some, it was scary. For others, it was just a simple challenge. While on the other hand, some people saw it as a whole adventure. And I'm quite sure for the graduating class of 2020, high school left a huge impact on each of our lives. I remember the first day in high school, we felt like aliens in a whole new environment. We were looking immaculate, for here's a nice room, neatly attired in our respective uniforms, and shoes as clean as a whistle. Like myself, I'm quite sure many of us weren't focused on what was taking place in the ocean, because nervousness got the best of us, and we were also too busy observing and chatting with new friends. After the devotional exercise, we went to our classes in an orderly fashion, where the form teachers introduced themselves. For us, our form teachers were like guardian angels. They were mommy and daddy at school, and we knew if anything happened, we could go to them. We had to adjust to the gender classes, which were implemented in our year group. There were two classes with all boys and two with all girls. This continued until grade 9. When we got to grade 10, we branched off into business, arts, science, and the general studies. Of course, over a period of time, things began to get normal. We had all settled in and we made new friends. Like any typical high school, we had the cool kids who would pay other persons to go and purchase their lunches. The game heads who would save their money every day in order to go to the games room. We had the introverts who were not very friendly. We had the extremely good kids who would do anything to be the apple of the teacher's eyes. And the list goes on. There are many memories in high school that I'm quite sure will take us back to these past years we spent at Iona. For example, Mr. Hall's everyday words, which include, "You're digging a hole for yourself." He'd mainly say this if a child did something to distract the class, and whenever he didn't want to go back and forth with the student, he'd usually say, "Anyways, to be continued." We would also never forget the teacher's dedication to their different subject areas and students. To say they stuck with us through thick and thin would be an understatement. Oh, how we wished some of them would just be late for classes at least once. Or even better, not turn up. What damage could just a little fun do? We also have Mrs. Ferguson, who is bittersweet. She's the teacher our students can't play with. I'd never forget how serious she could have been. For example, if someone entered the class without saying good morning, she'd usually say, "Wait, you woke up and saw me at your house this morning. Go find your manners and come back." But despite how feisty she could have been, she was serious about us doing our work. And I'm pretty sure the whole class of 2020 can probably say that she was someone we could always relate to. We also had other dedicated teachers like Miss Allen, who almost lost her mind when she heard that the government would be closing school during the pandemic. "No, no, 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 the kids aren't ready. The picnic is not ready. Students, students, come, we need to create a group for you students. You really aren't ready. I need someone to come and talk about it." The students could barely get to redress in peace. Our grade coordinator, Miss Nelson, would be suited to solve any problems. Mrs. Samuda Henry, who was so patient and kind with the high-headed math students. Miss Napier brought life to Iona with her great vibes. Miss Miller, who really excused us from being physical education. Mr. Murphy, who also brought a lot of vibes and enjoyed teaching music. Mr. Glenn Williams, he could be very feisty also, but when it comes on to accounts, you've got to ensure that the checkbook is perfectly written up. He turned up to class in his favorite pair of black shoes, which he'd always tell us his grandfather gave to him, and his Tommy Hilfiger glasses, and he would be sure he never leave the humor behind. Mrs. Maxine Gilling-White, who led the most active club, Key Club, and as the immediate past president, I will never forget the many memories we shared together. She was the best faculty advisor any school across the globe could have ever asked for, and I will never forget how she encourages each and every member to maximize their fullest potential. Even though her way of doing so was a bit stern, we appreciate her for the morals and values she has instilled in us to take us through our life's journey. Yes, we had many other clubs at Iona, but none as outstanding as Key Club. Another thing that will be extremely difficult to forget are the nicknames given to different students in our year group, such as Kaushan, Mati, Banga, Zaza, Dora, Joppa, Elda, Mosquito or Skita, Krebe, Bula, and Angel. We also had our own Usain Bolt, Sanjay Banga Ivory, who was always ready and waiting to place first in races. The class of 2020 also experienced eventful years in grades 7 and 10. In grade 7, we were able to be a part of the experience where school entered all together sing and came second. And in grade 10, where school celebrated 70 years of existence. We were also very happy when many changes started taking place. The new canteen breastfeeding official. Our ties, belts, and crests changed. And most exciting of all, we finally got new classrooms we've been paying for all these years, thanks to Food for the Poor and Ray Cochran. Many of us lost ourselves in high school, while others were just finding themselves. But I really think it's safe to say that despite the many rainy days we've experienced, the sun still managed to outshine the rainy days. There are many lessons learned in high school. For me, I learned that it is important for students to know that high school is the beginning of the journey. But in most cases, the journey never ends. As long as we have life, there will always be room for improvement. I learned that I should not settle for less. I shouldn't be afraid to take it to the next level, because many opportunities may await me. But how can I make good use of these opportunities if I am only willing to remain at my current stage? My fellow graduates, we should be willing to look forward to new things. Make progress. Be willing to start over if we have to. We should also be willing to not just settle for what is considered good enough, but to do our best, because only our best is good enough.
A few months before the pandemic, our alma mater was rehearsed at several devotional exercises. There were times when we sang the alma mater out of respect. There were other times when we sang just because we were told to. For the most part, we just wanted the devotion to end so we could go and rest our weary feet. How many of us ever look back and recognize that this simple task was a luxury that was robbed from us since March? My fellow graduates, please stand with me for the rendition of our alma mater.
Online classes.
Students also encourage each other to continue studying, although we doubted the reality of sitting the external exams this year. This would not be possible without the unmeasurable faith of our teachers and students under the leadership of our principal, Mrs. Melba Lewis Johnson. I therefore take this opportunity to thank our principal, Mrs. Hughes Johnson, teachers, and graduating class of 2020. Thank you, Iona, we salute thee. As we move on from this noble institution, I encourage all of us to take our core values, not as words written on the blocks of Iona, but use them to impact our lives and that of others in a positive way. Take collaboration and work assiduously with members of your community to transform lives that will contribute positively to our country. Continue to mentally mold yourselves with honesty and integrity. Whatever you do, do so with honesty and integrity. No one may see your actions, but remember, God is watching you, and whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. We have no idea of what life will be like after this pandemic. Some of us may not be able to go to college. Some of us may wait in vain for an interview or a dream job. Hence, let productivity bring out the best in you. Utilize all platforms of natural and man-made resources to innovate your own means of survival. I hope the next 5 to 10 years from now, at least 20% of us will become famous as a result of creativity. The story of the invention of airplane in 1903 by the Wright brothers benefited the world because they unleashed the creativity in them. The creation of their first airplane, known as Flyer One, was inspired by their favorite toy, which happened to be an airplane. Fortunately for us, this cherished toy broke. As a result, they decided to create their own airplane, not as a toy this time. Their idea was actually a big joke in the ears of many. The Wright brothers were deemed as being ridiculous because in the minds of others, only birds fly. Did they allow what other people thought to stop them? They unleashed their creativity into the invention of a transportation that is beneficial to the entire world. They did all that with the limited resources they had. Imagine what we can do with all we have at our fingertips now. Raise your hand if you believe you are the first member of this graduating class to create history as the Wright brothers. Throughout our lives, as young as we are, we will encounter defeats. According to Maya Angelou, you may encounter many defeats, but you must not be defeated. In fact, it may be necessary to encounter the defeats so you can know who you are, what you can rise from, and how you can still come out of it. The key factor in our defeat is perseverance. Never stop until your mission is accomplished. Last but not least, self-respect. Respect yourself, my fellow graduates. Respect has nothing to do with age. You earn it or lose it. Graduates of 11 arts, science, business, and general studies, we officially leave here today at the same time, but our dreams will be accomplished at different times. Each one of us has a different timing on our lives. Continue to mold yourselves with these core values, a task that Iona took on 5 years ago for the most of us. And in the end, it's not the years in your life that counts, it's life in your years. Abraham Lincoln. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Ladies and gentlemen, I now invite a prefect to come forward, a solid young man of this institution, Mr. Odean Pink, as he will make the introduction of the guest speaker.
Chairperson, Ms. Kadeen Allen, School Chaplain, Reverend Kalunga, guest speaker, Mrs. Denise Shaw McKinnon, Deputy Superintendent of Police, Mr. Dwight Hollett, Representative of the Ministry of Education Region 2, Board Chairman, Mr. Jasper Lawrence, Principal, Mrs. Melba Hughes Johnson, Mrs. Joan Peart Armstrong, Vice Principal, Alumni Representative, Mr. Michael Watkins, Reverend Osborne Jarrett, PTA President, Graduates, Members of Staff of Iona, Ladies and Gentlemen, good day. It is not coincidental that the theme for this COVID-inspired graduation is surmounting obstacles, charting a positive future. Neither is it by chance that we have this very special keynote speaker in the person of Mrs. Denise Shaw McLean. She is, after all, licensed to serve, protect, and counsel. This stalwart personality is often one who stands between us and insanity that might hold us hostage to perpetrators of crime. She holds the title of Deputy Superintendent of Police in charge of chaplaincy, headquarters, and administration in the Jamaica Constabulary Force. But with qualification extending to a diploma in education, a degree in guidance and counseling, a bachelor, a master in psychology, and an impending doctoral degree in psychology, she has blended the best of both worlds. It is therefore not surprising that she is a consultant with the Northeastern Regional Health Authority and the Department of Correction, both areas where I am sure her expertise and experience must be invaluable. Not to be forgotten is the fact that she is an elder, a preacher, and motivational speaker. She is also a mother of two. We therefore could not ask for a more suitable, qualified person to address us at this time when we are on the course of our future. But a time which made all the more transformative, curious, and unpredictable because of the appearance of COVID-19. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce to you Mrs. Denise Shaw McKinnon, Deputy Superintendent of Police, who will no doubt give a valuable counsel on how to pilot through this uncharted terrain that faces us. Mrs. McKinnon.